What are dreams and what's happening to us when we're dreaming?
So dreams are like friends. They're trying to give you some advice. A bit like somebody's got some useful information for you, a bit like an observer, somebody on the outside looking in can see something that you can't. But like a lot of our friends, we either take what they say with a pinch of salt or we might take them seriously.
Okay.
So when you're dreaming, really, it's an opportunity to learn something that's going to help you in your daily life.
Oh.
But apparently, Delphi, a lot of people dream about losing their teeth.
Yes.
And remember, my mum, when I was very, very young, she had a gum disease thing and they took all her teeth out under gas in one day.
Yeah.
And I have to say, I dread that, but a lot of people dream about it.
They do. It's one of the most common dreams that people have. And actually, there's lots of different reasons why we dream, but with the losing teeth, it's really interesting because culturally, it can mean different things to different people. So, for example, I've met some people who, culturally, if they dream of losing their teeth, it might be a fear of losing somebody that they love. Mm. Whereas if, say, for example, you've grown up like we do in this country, what do you do when you lose your tooth as a child? What do you do?
Put it under the pillow.
Yeah, you exchange it for money.
Yeah.
So in this day and age, generally speaking, if you're dreaming of losing your teeth, it can mean that you're worrying about money. It could be to do with status and wealth.
And Colin would be worried about eating, wouldn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah. It can be literal, though.
So this thing that we always hear, because I very rarely remember my dreams, we always hear that we definitely dream every night. And if we don't, that can affect our mental health. Is that true?
Well, what we know is that we do all dream every single night, even if you're not remembering them. What we do also know about dreams is that it's the process of dreaming that helps you store your memory. So it's more likely if you're not remembering your dreams or you're not sleeping well, then you might find that your memory is affected. But what we do know also about dreaming is that we dream up to 3 or 4 times a night. So everybody is dreaming every single night.
There's even lots, if you don't remember
even
them.
If you don't remember
them. Are you sleeping badly if you don't remember them?
It could be that, yeah. It could be that. But it could also be the culture that you grew up in. You know, if you grew up in an environment where, say, you had a bad dream as a child and you told your caregiver, your mum, your dad, and they said, oh, don't worry, your dreams don't mean anything, then you're less likely to remember them as you grow up.
Yeah.
But in the same way, women are more likely to remember their dreams than men. People who meditate are more likely to remember their dreams than those who don't. So it's really down to the individual and the kind of environment they grow up in.
Sorry, I'm not allowed another question.
I have to ask you about the myths of dreams. Mm. So there's that one that if you dream that you're falling...
Yeah.
And you don't wake up before you hit the bottom, you die.
Yeah, so the question I always say to people, this is a common myth and I've heard people ask me this before, the question I always say to people is, how would you know? Because if you died in your dream, you wouldn't be around to tell anybody. So what I do say to people is, the good news is I have met people who have fallen in a dream and they hit the bottom and live to tell the tale. But dreaming of falling, there's kind of two reasons why we have it. One is, for some people, it's very common after a bereavement. It's common after... for example, retirement, a bit like Alice going down the rabbit hole.
Yeah.
But it's also a bit like, for some people, if you've ever had that experience, just as you're dozing off into a lovely sleep where you feel like you've done that. And that's what's known as a hypnic jerk, and that can be a symptom of stress. So it's always worth keeping that in your mind as well, factoring that into it.
Very quickly, obviously, we're going to go through our dreams, and we'll start with mine. We were thinking about what our most recurring dream is.
Yeah.
So mine, I was thinking, right, okay, recurring stress dream. Mine is that I'm trying to get somewhere. I can never get there. I'm missing trains, buses, everything else. And then the closer I'm getting, I end up, I look down, I'm not wearing any clothes, and I need the toilet, and I cannot get to a toilet, and because every toilet I go to is dirty and horrible, and I don't want to go in that toilet. So then I just think, I'll hold it in. So I end up, I'm late, I'm naked, I need the toilet, they're all dirty, and then they've got no toilet doors, and it's all open, and it's like something out of train spotting, and I wake up really not very happy.
Sure.
What does that mean?
Well, there's lots of elements to that dream. The first is, whenever you dream that you're on public transport or you're waiting for public transport, that can be to do with how you're connecting with people socially. And a bit like we say in metaphor, I've missed the bus on that, it could be that you've missed an opportunity or you worry that you've missed an opportunity.
So that's a bit like yours, Nadia, waiting for a bus.
Well, I don't remember my dreams, but the only one I do is standing by a bus stop, which makes me feel like I'm the most boring person in the world.
It's good. Sometimes if the dreams are boring, that can be a good sign, because it means there isn't much to worry about. If we are having those types of dreams.
I have a few recurring dreams, but one in particular It's very distressing because I dream that the baby is in a room and the door is closed and I haven't fed it. I've forgotten to feed the baby. And I waken up... Yours the same? And I waken up in such a panic. So what is that?
So sometimes what happens during the day can influence what we dream about at night. So if, say, for example, you've heard a baby crying in public and you might be thinking to yourself, your maternal instincts kick in, somebody feed that baby or something like that, that might be why you dream it at night. If you've lost a child, then it's perfectly normal in a way. It makes perfect sense that you might be dreaming about where they are.
You might be dreaming about Karen, for
example. Exactly, yeah. But also, dreaming of babies is very much about how well you're looking after yourself. So if you're taking good care of yourself, then you're less likely to have that dream, whereas if you're worried about your health and well-being, you might have that dream.
Just really quickly, we've got about 30 seconds for my dream. I dream that I'm being chased all the time, but they're running normal speed and I can only run in slow motion and can't get away.
Being chased in a dream is usually about a fear of something catching up with you, like a deadline, for example, getting behind with something. And often with people, they feel like they can't move in their dreams, they can't get away, and that's just the body way of saying you're physically paralysed when you're dreaming, so you can't get away from it, but also metaphorically, you might need to confront whatever it is that you're trying to get away from or that's catching up with you.
That was perfect timing as well.
Thank you so much.
That was great. Oh, we hope you enjoyed that.